Exhale. 3, 2, 1, engage.
There it is. We are doing this training because the X-59 is going to be flying probably well above 50,000 feet. And when you start getting to altitudes above about 40,000 feet, simply breathing oxygen, 100% oxygen, isn't enough to keep an aviator conscious. Above about 40,000 feet, you actually have to start delivering pressure or pressurizing the lungs of the aviator in order for them to actually be able to stay conscious. The higher you go, the more pressure you have to provide. Well, the emergency that we're concerned about would be a loss of cabin pressure. It isn't something you want to have happen for the very first time if you lose the cabin pressure of your aircraft at 54,000 feet. So today was all about learning how to breathe when a regulator is delivering pressure. A lot of pressure. 60 millimeters of mercury of pressure, and it's quite a bit.
In 3, 2, 1, pressure. Remember to square off that breathing.
A normal breathing pattern for humans is active inhalation and passive exhalation. So positive pressure breathing, what we're doing in this training, reverses that process. So now inhalation is a passive process. If you just relax everything, it blows you up like a balloon. And then you have to actively exhale, squeeze muscles in your chest in order to push that air back out again.
In 3, 2, 1, pressure.
The training starts off at low pressure and then we work our way up. So we start off with 15 millimeters mercury of pressure. And that lets the student kind of get a feel for what it's like to do the breathing technique that we teach to make sure that they avoid hypocapnia or hyperventilation.
I'm going to go ahead and drop your mask.
Then they go up to 30 millimeters mercury for 30 seconds. That most aviators have ever experienced is about 30. However, the system in the X-59 can deliver as much as 72 millimeters of mercury. Now, and for training, we take them up to 60. We give them a quick experience at 60, about 10 seconds, where they can really experience what it feels like to have that kind of pressure pushed into your lungs. Once they've recovered from that, we'll talk about it, and then we give them another 30 seconds at 60 millimeters of mercury.
You ready, ma'am?
I'm ready.
You're ramped up to full pressure.
There's a lot of reasons to get down and get down as quickly as possible, and this system is designed exactly to do that. It's intended to keep you alive until you can get below an altitude where you no longer need it.